I wasn't planning on making a video out of this, but I just had to after this difficult day. To continue use with Bentley's new saddlebag harness that I talked about in my last video, and to test out my new GoPro style camera that I got for myself for my upcoming birthday, me and a friend went on a short hike in Patapsco Valley State Park on a short but scenic trail loop for what I thought was going to be another fun trek with the dogs. We got everything together with plenty of water. For Ben's weight in his saddlebag, we used 2 12-ounce Gatorades. Things seemed to be going okay at the start. They interacted with another dog in a large group. There was no barking, no pulling. Ben was listening. Stella was a little confused because she's never walked with anybody besides Nick or myself. Our troubles began almost immediately after that. They seemed so full of energy that all of the leash training that we've worked for months on seemed to be thrown right out the window. Ben would not stop pulling and was at the end of his leash almost the entire time. No matter how many times I would make him stop or go backwards or try and make him wait, he just seemed unable to control himself. He just wanted to do what he wanted to do. Stella as well was pulling and jumping at least twice as much as she normally does, although I'm not sure if that's because Ben was going nuts or if because she had someone new walking her that she felt she could get away with her bad behavior. We finally got to the waterfall we were heading to and started down to the water. Stella had to be carried down in some spots because she's a bit nervous. Then, as we got close, I realized there were 2 snakes in the brush next to me. One about 4 feet long and the other of the same kind about 2 feet long. My camera was around my neck, but as I tried to grab it and snap a picture of these perfectly placed snakes, Bentley started wildly barking and pulling toward the people next to us. I was trying to get Ben under control and calm so that I could snap a picture, but by the time I got him under control, all of his barking had scared away the bigger snake and the smaller one had started slithering off as well. Based off of their colorings, their round eyes, and the fact that we were right next to water, I'm fairly certain that they were northern water snakes, although they could have been rat snakes. Either way, non-venomous. We played in the water for a bit, but Bentley continued barking randomly at people around us. It seems to be a bad habit that he's picked up within the last 2 weeks or so. To keep the peace and to get the dogs in a more comfortable place, we got out of there. But instead of continuing the 2 miles back to the car using the loop, we head back the way we came, just under a mile. These pups seemed not to want to behave at all, and normally I'd sit and work with them, but with the amount of people on the sometimes narrow trail, it made it really difficult to stop. It was also a trail they hadn't gone on before, so I think all of the new sights and smells made their bad tempers even worse. We came back home and played in the backyard to get out some of their restlessness. Since then, they've seemed fine, have been chewing on bones or sleeping at my feet in a pile of cuteness. In the future, on new trails, I think I'll play with them for a bit first to help get out some of that excess energy so that they can focus on me more and what I'm trying to get them to do and not be on the edge of their leash the entire time. Normally, they are much more well-behaved, but today, they just were not having it. It's one of the adventures of having a dog and something to keep in mind. Thanks for watching and hearing about Ben and Stella's off day to day at the trails. Dogs aren't always as perfect as they seem on Instagram. It's a learning process for everyone. If you have any of your own stories, I'd love to hear about them in the comments down below. Take care, don't forget, reapply your sunscreen.